Some of the scientific research shows evidence that temperature and humidity are negatively associated with the COVID-19. So the situation can get worse when we enter the fall. And I do not see any, you know, vaccine coming out before the end of 2020. It seems that we do not have other choice than fighting the virus spread and trying to maintain economic activities at the same time. It is part of the new normal, in my opinion.
If you want to look at the health of the corporate, can be divided it into two different group of companies, a big companies and small company, small medium enterprise. So you look at the big companies, I don't think there could be a problem, okay? Because look at the debt equity ratio, the gas availability from the worst sector like airline sector or oil and gas sector, when the oil price is like $20 per barrel. Actually, the big companies can handle it well. And even they can take market share from a smaller company. My conclusion is after the COVID, the bigger get bigger, the big get bigger, the small will disappear. And that's the market consolidation happening, okay? So you look at the small and medium enterprise, my prediction is at least 10 to 15% of the companies are out business, okay? So that's not small about all companies. That will explain to the 2 million people job loss. But remember, 2 million job loss is not a big number. 2 million, you divide by 60 million workforce in Vietnam, that's 3.3% unemployment. So that will cover only the tourism sector and hospitality sector. So don't be surprised. And the buffer for that is to look at the agriculture sector in Vietnam. That is a buffer, even though that sector doesn't contribute a big part of the GDP. But when you are unemployed from the industrial park or whatever, you go back to rural area and work with your father and your mom. Okay, so that helps you. So that doesn't create, like, in my view, it does income expenditure or disposable expenditure is going down. But I would say, it will not impact the stability of Vietnam economy. So that's my view.
What can the government do more? I think innovative measures were suggested to boost the public investment disbursement. For example, turning the PPP project, public-private partnership project, into the public investments. For the private consumption, I think it represents around 65 to 70% of the GDP. But it's not easy to increase it, and we understand why. People are very, you know, worried about the future prospect of the economy. So they prefer saving. In some countries, I remember, like even in France, the more the government helps workers, the more money goes to the banks.
Look at what China in the 90s and 2000, look at Taiwan back in the 80s, look at Japan in the 60s, look at Korea in the 1780s. They deliver 10 to 12% growth. If Vietnam any chance to get out in mid-income trap or whatever you name it, we need to grow 10%. And we merely deliver 7%, 6.5%. The reason is because we are not that decisive in policy. Given the ingredient, the thing we have in Vietnam, and if the fiscal policy needs to be a bit more decisive, you look at the last 3 years, you don't have a lot of fiscal into infrastructure investment. That's a bottleneck for Vietnam economy, okay? You look at FDI coming in, they always complain about logistic costs in Vietnam, right? The problem with Vietnam is the system to distribute the money to the poor people. It's not easy. It's unlike the US when you have a banking system, banking and the taxpayer, and you can distribute the money. Vietnam, we don't have that. So to give free money to people, it's not that simple in terms of mechanism. So the fiscal is a key one. And the fiscal, given this, if you push fiscal into infrastructure investment, that could help Vietnam so much in the next 3 to 5 years. And that, for that, if they do it the way they promise, I will be very bullish, okay? The second is whether the monetary policy is enough or not. I think the central bank is a bit late in terms of stimulate the economy. I think they should aggressively cut the rate given inflation is low. The central bank did cut rate a bit more aggressive. They did it before. They did it in the last 1 month is good. But at the beginning, March, I think they was a bit slow. My expectation given COVID second round happening, I think the rate will be cut further because of inflation. Do you don't see inflation? Currency has been the best currency in the world, right? And it keep very solid. So I think money policy should be even more aggressive. The reason I'm not worried about inflation is, actually I'm a bullish on inflation, not only this time, had been many years already. You look at, you can complain the global commodity is going up right now, right? But if you look at closely, you look at pork. Pork is one of the key inflation driver in Vietnam and in China. And pork price has been testing at the peak level, like $5 per kilogram already in Vietnam. And you look at the translation of pork price, remember the killer for Vietnam inflation back in 2011 was pork, not much on money policy, okay? And pork this time is like record high. Translation to the food inflation is about 13%. And the average inflation for the first 6 months, 2.3% only, already taken pork into account. And the government always have healthcare and education to kind of maneuver inflation number, okay? So I would strongly believe this year we can well control inflation below 4%. And given the velocity of money going down so much, you know, velocity of money, it has been like 2.5 and now it's like, look at the economy globally and Vietnam, velocity of money has been slowing down. So whatever money you print out from the central bank, we not be able to compensate for the money velocity going up, going down, right? So that from that perspective, inflation in my view will remain low, but inflation expectation in the future is still low given the consumption behavior. But there is indication of dollars weakening globally. When the dollar weakening globally, I think emerging market currency, soft currency, should be fine. Okay. So, and you look at the balance payment in Vietnam, normally when the economy weakens, the currency normally is stable because of you look at import, you look at trade surplus has been about, if you're traveling, it's about $16 billion surplus in the last 12 months already, right? So from that perspective, I'm quite bullish on the currency and inflation.